Good afternoon and welcome to Washington National Cathedral and the service of Choral Evensong. The service is one of song evening prayer, and we gather together in the ancient tradition of people of God offering prayer and praise at the close of the day. If this is your first visit to Washington National Cathedral, a special welcome to you on this Independence Day weekend. Again, welcome. And please join in singing hymn 549, found in your service leaflet. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him. O Lord, open thou our lips.
And the mouth shall show forth thy praise.
God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make peace to them us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as
Praise ye the Lord.
The Lord's name be praised.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A lesson from the book of Numbers, wherein Joshua is appointed the successor of Moses. The Lord said to Moses, "Go up this mountain of the Abram range and see the land that I have given to the Israelites. When you have seen it, you also shall be gathered to your people as your brother Aaron was, because you rebelled against my word in the wilderness of Zin when the congregation quarreled with me. You did not show my holiness before thy eyes at the waters. These are the waters of Meribah and Kadesh in the wilderness of Zin." Moses spoke to the Lord, saying, "Let the Lord, the God of the spirits of all flesh, appoint someone over the congregation who shall put out before them and come in before them, who shall lead them out and bring them in, so that the congregation of the Lord may not be like a sheep without a shepherd." So the Lord said to Moses, "Take Joshua, son of Nun, a man who is in the spirit, and lay your hand upon him. Have him stand before Eleazar, the priest, and all the congregation, and commission him in their sight. You shall give him some of your authority, so that all the congregation of the Israelites may obey. But he shall stand before Eleazar, the priest, who shall inquire of him by the decision of Urim before the Lord. At his word, they shall go out, and at his word, they shall come in, both he and all the Israelites with him, the whole congregation." So Moses did as the Lord commanded. He took Joshua and had him stand before Eleazar the priest and the whole congregation. He laid his hands on him and commissioned him as the Lord had directed through Moses. Here ends the lesson.
My soul, oh, what of my life, if I know? A lesson from the Gospel according to St. Luke, wherein Jesus calls his first disciples. Now, after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news." As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went a little farther, he saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men and followed him. Here ends the lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the state,
and
thy ministers with righteousness,
and make thy chosen people joyful.
O Lord, save thy people,
and bless thy inheritance.
Give peace in our time, O Lord,
because there is none other that fighteth for us, but only thou, O God.
O God, make clean our hearts within us, to keep all thy commandments by loving thee and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of thy Holy Spirit, that we may be devoted to thee with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the same Spirit, one God forever and ever. Lord God, whose Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, triumphed over the powers of death and prepared for us our place in the new Jerusalem, grant that we, who have this day given thanks for his resurrection, may praise thee in that city of which he is the light, and where he liveth and reigneth forever and ever. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give thine angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for thy love's sake. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you are able. A prayer for the nation. Lord God Almighty, you have made all the peoples of the earth for your glory, to serve you in freedom and in peace. Give to the people of our country a zeal for justice and the strength of forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Praying together. Almighty God, the Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. God's blessing be with you, Christ's peace be with you, and the Spirit's outpouring be with you now and always. Amen. Our closing hymn is 661, found in your service leaflet.